The Schluter KERDI-BOARD-SNLT shower niche integrates Schluter LIPROTEC LED technology to bring warm accent lighting to your shower. The LIPROTEC LED provides evenly diffused light along the length of the strip for a smooth and visually appealing result. And the integrated system ensures that the assembly is code compliant. Let's take a look at the system components. There are three parts to consider. First, the KERDI-BOARD-SNLT shower niche incorporates a waterproof LED light strip with a mounting profile and features a connection box that inserts into the pre-installed cavity at the top of the niche. This allows for access to the wire connection as required by code. The niche is available in several different sizes, designed for vertical and horizontal installation. Please note that if you are installing one of the Schluter shelf end shelves in the KERDI-BOARD-SNLT niches, we recommend installing the shelf in the lower section of the niche to maximize the illuminated area. A box of KERDI-BOARD ZT washers and ZS screws is also included for installation of the niche. There are 8 screws and washers included to accommodate all sizes of the niche offered. Finally, a KERDI-BOARD frame allows for secure waterproofing for the KERDI-BOARD-SNLT assembly within the shower area. Second are the power supply options. LIPROTEC-ECX is an all-in-one LED power supply and in-wall dimmer switch from Schluter-Systems. It fits all standard electrical boxes and eliminates compatibility issues between drivers and dimmer switches. LIPROTEC-ECX comes with 3 different color faceplates to match most decors: mounting screws, twisted wire connectors, and a snap-on voltage barrier to separate the low and high voltage power connections, and is required for installation of the LIPROTEC-ECX. LIPROTEC-ECD is an inline dimmable driver that is hardwired into your electrical. It is compatible with a range of dimming switches available on the market, allowing you to have matching light switches throughout your bathroom. A smart dimmer can also be used to integrate the ECD with your home automation system. Refer to the compatibility guide on Schluter.com for a list of compatible dimmer switches. The ECD dimmable driver comes with a UL-listed certified enclosure, or J-box, a driver, all necessary mounting hardware, non-metallic cable strain relief, and WAGO lever connectors. Finally, a cable is required to connect the system together. LIPROTEC CW connection cables are rated for in-wall installation. There is no conduit required. The cables feature pre-installed waterproof snap-in glands and connectors. Let's take a look at the installation of the system. In this installation, we are installing a vertically designed niche. The horizontal installation is the same process. As always, before beginning installation, make sure that your niche will be properly supported by studs or pre-constructed wall framing, and that there is proper spacing for the connection box. If you have questions, please consult with your builder or local building code official to determine that framing construction is compliant with all local building code. We'll start with demonstrating one of the power supply options: the LIPROTEC ECD dimmable driver with enclosure. The other power supply option to choose from is the LIPROTEC ECX. We'll demonstrate that installation later in this video. Prior to installation, it is necessary to determine where the power source will be mounted, how the cables are to be run to the niche, and any other electrical requirements. This is important to determine the length of the cable you will need for installation. Adjacent closets, underneath vanities, in the basement are all possibilities when considering placement of the driver. Orientation of the LIPROTEC ECD is not critical. The location must be outside of the shower with ease of access in a dry area. The LIPROTEC ECD cannot be installed closer than 2 inches from cabinet walls or in a compartment smaller than 17.5 by 8.5 by 4.25 inches. Since bathroom environments can be damp, the ECD is rated for this condition also. In this installation, we'll be installing the ECD dimmable driver in a closet adjacent to the shower. This product must be installed by a qualified person in accordance with the installation instructions and with the Canadian Electrical Code Part 1 or the National Electrical Code as applicable. All electric connections must be made by a qualified person according to the electrical and building codes effective in your region. Again, the applicable wires have been run to their predetermined location. The power has been shut off at the circuit breaker. determine the appropriate knockouts on the enclosure that the wire will be run through. There are several options available. Using a screwdriver and hammer, punch out the appropriate knockouts. Attach the non-metallic cable strain relief fittings to the knockouts. Thread the cables through the fittings, making sure to line up the cables with the applicable side of the ECD, the low voltage with the output and high voltage with input. Check for level and mark the wall for mounting. The LIPROTEC ECD enclosure should be fastened to a stud with the included hardware. If this is not possible, we recommend using drywall anchors, as shown here. Install the anchors if necessary and reposition the enclosure on the wall. Secure the cable strain relief fittings and fasten the enclosure to the wall with screws. Strip the cables if necessary. The included WAGO lever connectors provide a guide for any stripping of the cables that may be required. Now it's time to make the connections. The LED driver enclosure must be grounded in accordance with local and national electric codes. Ground the enclosure with the included green grounding screw. LIPROTEC ECD LED drivers are Class II certified and do not require a direct ground connection or ground fault circuit interrupter. Make the connections as follows on the high voltage AC side. Connect the primary neutral wires, or white to white. Then, connect the primary hot wires, or black to black. On the opposite end of the enclosure, connect the low voltage DC wires together. First, the positive wires, or red to red. Next, connect the negative wires, or black to black. Once the connections have been made, fasten the lid to the enclosure. To complete the connections of the LIPROTEC ECD, the work will resume where we plan to install the dimmer. We are installing a single pole dimmer that is compatible with the LIPROTEC ECD. Check out the compatibility guide found at Schluter.com. We are installing in a double-gang electrical box to ensure proper space for the wires. Make the connections as per the dimmer manufacturer's instructions. If the niche opening is prepared or your walls are open, now would be an optimal time to test the LED. Temporarily turn on the power for testing. Use caution when disconnecting the LED. There is a small locking tab on the connector that needs to be lifted slightly before the connectors can be separated. The installation of the LIPROTEC ECD is now complete. The other power supply option to choose from is the LIPROTEC-ECX. When installing the LIPROTEC-ECX all-in-one LED driver and dimmer switch, the process is as follows. First things first, determine where the switch box will be installed and connected to the main power. Then, how the cables are to be run to the niche and any other electrical requirements. This is important to determine the length of the cable you will need for installation. Keep in mind that the 120-volt input cable needs to be at the bottom of the electrical box. Another reminder, this product must be installed by a qualified person in accordance with the installation instructions and with the Canadian Electrical Code Part 1 or the National Electrical Code as applicable. All electric connections must be made by a qualified person according to the electrical and building codes effective in your region. The power has been shut off at the circuit breaker. Our demonstration will be done in a double-gang electrical box to show how the LIPROTEC ECX can be installed next to an existing switch. Make sure to position the housing slider and faceplate slider at minimum brightness to properly secure the faceplate. Choose a faceplate finish and attach it to the dimmer. Dry fit the dimmer up to the junction box to determine if removal of the fins is necessary. remove the fins using pliers if required. Note that unlike standard high-voltage AC controls, removing the fins on the LIPROTEC-ECX does not reduce the dimmer's maximum wattage rating. We are installing a partition in order to separate the high-voltage room lighting from the ECX wiring. The partition is not included with the ECX. A voltage barrier is provided with the ECX that is required to separate the high-voltage and low-voltage wires in the wall box. Attach the voltage barrier to the back of the dimmer. For shallow boxes, the barrier can be shortened. Strip the wires on the dimmer if needed. Make the connections using the supplied connectors on the back of the dimmer as follows. First, ground the box. Next, work on the 24-volt connections at the top of the dimmer. Connect the red wire to red wire, followed by the blue wire to black wire. Move on to the 120-volt connections at the bottom of the box. Start by connecting the neutral wire from the home to the white wire, and then the line wire from the home to the black wire. The connections for the ECX are now complete. Mount the dimmer to the wall and secure using the supplied screws. If the niche opening is prepared or your walls are open, now would be an optimal time to test the LED. Temporarily turn on the power for testing. Finish the installation by securing the trim plate to the ECX. The installation of the LIPROTEC ECX is now complete. The next step is to install the KERDI-BOARD SNLT niche and make the connections. We have determined the placement of the niche so that the opening aligns with the joints in the wall tile to minimize tile cuts and produce even grout lines. Keep in mind that you need to consider your grout joint width, shower base thickness, any perimeter profiles, and thin set mortar in your layout measurements. Cut the opening for the niche and dry fit. Pull down the LIPROTEC CW connection cable slightly. Test the LED before installation into the niche. Insert the metal connection box into the cavity at the top of the niche and hold it in place, ensuring the side holes are aligned. Bring the niche to the wall and guide the cable with the connector on the end to the intended position for the cable gland at the niche. Insert the cable with the wire into the hole on the side of the black box. Push the clamping end of the gland into the hole until you hear a click. Be sure the flange on the gland is flush and sits tightly onto the outside of the box. The gland should not be moved from its current position on the cable. They are torqued to be watertight, and loosening them could result in leaks. Insert the niche and fasten to the studs using the included KERDI-BOARD ZT washers and ZS screws. Apply a small piece of masking tape to create a tab on the end of the LIPROTEC CW. This will provide protection against any thin-set mortar during the next steps of installation, and also help to retrieve the cable from the connection box when the LED is ready to be installed. Snap the stainless steel cover into place, with the cable passing through the opening in the cover. Tuck the cable up into the box. Check the position of the slot on the top of the profile and the opening in the box cover to confirm alignment. For LED placement at the wall, the open side of the cover should be toward the back. In this installation, we will be installing the LED in the middle, so the open side of the cover will face out. Dry fit the self-adhesive patch at the top of the niche. Mark the spot where the cable comes through. Cut a hole in the patch for the cable to pass through. Remove the paper backer from the patch and adhere it in position. Take care to avoid lumps or air pockets. The self-adhesive patch is used for proper thin-set mortar adhesion and to prevent mortar from entering the connection box. It is not intended for waterproofing. Waterproof the niche using the Schluter KERDI-BOARD frame in conjunction with thin-set mortar. tile the back of the niche and install the surrounding wall tile. Dry fit the mounting profile again to determine the position and direction of the anchoring leg, considering tile layout and finishing profiles around the niche. The mounting profile is installed in conjunction with the tile. To install the profile, trowel thin-set mortar on the top of the niche, being careful not to lose or damage the wire. Grab the tape with a pair of pliers and pull it down through the thin-set. In order to avoid thin-set mortar from getting into the channel on the profile, we previously placed a piece of masking tape over the opening in the mounting profile. A small hole should be added to make it easier to retrieve the tape tail on the wire so you can pull it out in the next steps. Embed the profile into the thin-set mortar. Install the finishing profile. And set the tile up to the mounting profile. Pull the wire down through the opening and clean any excess thin-set mortar from the tab. Be careful not to allow any mortar or grout to get into the mounting profile, especially the spaces at the ends, above the side tiles. Clean any excess mortar from the profiles immediately. Complete the tile installation and grout the installation. Once the tile has been set and grouted, the LED strip can be inserted. If you do test the fit of the LED strip into the mounting profile prior to grouting, it must be removed before you do so. A tab can be made with masking tape or the bag the LED is shipped in to facilitate removal. Again, it is important to remove the LED strip from the profile prior to grouting to avoid damage. Once the thin set has set and the grout has dried, the LED can be fully inserted. Remove the tape from the end of the wire. Plug the LED into the cable. It should click. Then, push the connection up through the slot in the back of the profile into the box above. Test the LED one last time. The ends of the LED will need to be pushed into the spaces in the mounting profile above the side tiles. Let the LED strip bow slightly in the center and position the cable so that it is aligned directly below the slot in the profile. Press the LED strip into the profile channel while guiding the cable through the slot into the connection box. Ensure that all the cable is properly inserted into the connection box. If the cable is positioned in the channel of the mounting profile, behind the LED strip will not sit flush. Take care not to pinch the wires or stress the LED. Run a clean cloth or finger back and forth across the LED tube to fully seat it. Fill in any gaps at the end of the LED above the tiles with grout or sealant. Clean the LED. If removal is needed and no tab was used, a thin plastic card can be inserted between the sides of the LED and mounting profile to protect the LED strip from damage. Once this is in place, a 1.5-inch putty knife can be used to pry the LED out of the profile far enough to grab it. The blade of the knife should be inserted between the plastic card and the side of the profile. Use care when doing so to avoid causing any damage to the LED strip. The installation of the system is now complete. See your shower in a whole new light with KERDI-BOARD-SNLT and LIPROTEC lighting technology. If you still have questions, please contact our customer support specialists. For more information on Schluter products, visit Schluter.com or check our YouTube channel to view our videos.